So this video is going to be entirely on religion, and it might take a while, but I'm going to rock it right now. First of all, I want to say some things about religion in general as a paradigm that people use. It's the oldest human, social, and intellectual convention there is. Religion is the arc of humanity from 100,000 years ago in the archaeological, paleontological, evolutionary, scientific timeline. Okay? The event horizon for religion is when people start to bury their dead, when people start to not can have grave goods and things with them, when people start to have shrines to animals and nature, when people start to do cave paintings and different things like art, non-functional, just like things that you would be carrying with you, extra dead weight. People start to, the entire idea is that people, as soon as people began to interact with the environment on another level, on a meta level, on a higher plane of, complex synthetic reasoning, analytical thinking, really honestly creative mindedness, this as soon as people started to display aptitudes for things like altruism and social identities, as soon as people started to create symbolic content that everyone could agree upon, and that's humanity, that's how humanity started, that's religion. So many of you don't understand that, that's obvious, that's cool, but you don't understand that, so everything else after that is wrong. When your trajectory is off right at the very beginning, you end up in a wildly different tangent than you would have if you had gone off the right trajectory to begin with, right? So if you look at the human evolutionary experience, it begins with religious functions. What are thought of and known as religious functions and are served in society as religious functions by religious practitioners, shamans, medicine men, scribes, bean counters. Those guys are the apparatus of the church in the ancient times, okay? People who developed little figurines, people who developed, designs and things and, all kinds of different things. Your experience as an animist in nature, interacting with the universe, that's all based on a religious methodology. Science is based on a religious methodology. You can't get outside of it. So science is also, especially when used as some kind of political tool against religion, entirely used as a reactionary force against religion. And ultimately, a lot of cases, it just reinforces what religion has already put in place, especially when you do social science. So when we have religion inherent in the world today, and you talk about it, like the only people who define religion are the Westboro Baptist Church or the Mormons or the Catholics or the Jehovah's Witnesses. You don't know anything about Quakers. You don't know anything about Buddhists. You don't know anything about, Flying Spaghetti Monster. You've never even considered, should the NFL be able to fucking say, hey, we don't have to pay taxes on the NFL anymore. We're filing as a 501c3, putting this, grand spectacle on for people's hopes and dreams. People are totally wrapped up in this thing. It's that which they hold the most important. It's what they live for. It's what they die for. It's what they fucking identify themselves as. That's not a religion, To me, your political party is your religion. I'm telling you, whatever you're doing as a human being, however you self-identify, whatever little group you put yourself into, whatever your little neo-tribalism gang is, whatever you're doing with yourself, it could be hip-hop, it could be gambling, it could be smoking crack, it could be fucking, it could be not doing anything, it could be nothing. It could be drawing, it could be art, it could be music, it could be fucking going to the park and being in nature. Whatever makes you tick, whatever you believe in, whatever your worldview, whatever you find that drives you and makes you who you are, that's your religion. That's the most important thing for you to understand about yourself, is that you need to know who you are and what you are and why you're here and what you came to do. And if you get that, you become fucking powerful. It's like you know, your Goku Super Saiyan status, you're like, you know, firecrackers, you can fly. Not really, but like, yeah, maybe, really, maybe, who's to say? If you use the mind and the experience and everything else for real every day to attack the experience, to attack the universal existence of things, and to be a primal nature at work, a force in the fucking world, if you're doing that and you keep the laws of karma, which are clearly in place and they're easily recognizable, there's reasons for them to be that way. You know, if you understand how to see the infinite nature of the chaos, if you understand how to regulate the body, if you understand how to pass through the veil of death, and you understand how to pass through the veil of birth, you can keep your consciousness moving for an indefinite period of time, immortal, forever. You know, you don't have to be a human being, like, oh, like in this moment I'm just born here now of woman and then I die, right? No, you could be like, no, I rode up in this bitch on a white elephant, you know what I'm saying? And now I'm gonna fucking reincarnate myself wherever I want in the future time, you know what I'm saying? That's whatever you want to be, whatever you want your religion to be, you can do it. And if you think your religion is no religion and you just have a religion of no religion, and what you have is honestly not very much better than what the stupid ass fucking Mormons have, okay? And they actually have some benefits to what they have. You gotta be an idiot to follow it, but you get something out of that. It's a great experience, you know what I'm saying? So you give up your, you know, intellectual dignity, and you know, your grasp on reality, your grasp on Jesus for sure, but you get all these social benefits out of it. So what I mean, come on, how can you say that religion does nothing for you? It does all kinds of things for all kinds of people all the time. You don't even know, fucking, even the Catholics, they're fucking terrible. If I could take the Catholic Church over, your Pope Ratsy Binger, whatever your name is, and you're watching this, let me tell you something, buddy. You need to turn your shit over to me right now. Come and find me. I'm going to tell you how to fucking run your ship so tight that this whole planet will be saved overnight. You'll be the one who did it, baby. You know what I'm saying? Don't get it twisted. You work for me, okay? Anyways, that's what I'm saying, though, all right? My religion is different than yours. You know what I'm saying? My religion is my own. And I gave none and all out as this experience of Pai Chi and of nothing and everything, of the mystic principles of reality and all of these other deep, deep Kabbalistic rhythms that just, you know, it syncs everything together. It tells you exactly why the emptiness is so important. You know, why the nun has to come first. You know, why? You want to know about my religion? I'll tell you about my religion, okay? My religion is none and all, okay? This is what that means. It means that I'm a Taoist, Hindu, Buddhist, Jewish, Christian, Muslim, pagan, animist, again, non-theist, polytheist, monotheist. You understand? All right. That means I'm when you see that little coexist bumper sticker, that represents me. That's what I'm all about. It's called interfaith. That's my gang. You know what I'm saying? I'm from the interfaith gang. You know what I'm saying? So the first thing I start with is Tai Chi. I recognize the essential principles of the cosmological formula, the framework for this entire existential reality. Okay, everything is just empty cups waiting to be filled. Everything, even the stuff filling into the empty cup, is just the empty cup waiting to be filled. Okay, that's all. The whole universe is essentially empty. This symbol right here is how things fucking are. Things are things because they have a boundary around them that makes them that thing. And the whole universe is built on littler things into bigger things, up and down endlessly, on and on and on and on and on. They just get bigger and bigger and bigger and smaller and smaller and smaller at the same time. And the one that really matters is the one that's right here in front of you right now. You know what I'm saying? You're worried about the reality that's so small you can't even see. Think about germs and microorganisms and fucking how the computers work, all this crazy shit. People who have to do that, they sacrifice their reality, their real reality, for you. That's a great thing for them. Good for them. Go and do that shit. I love you. My woman just got a job in a lab. That's awesome. Go science. Now, I want to tell you something else, though. Okay? There's next thing. Hinduism. I don't want to stay on Tai Chi for too long. This video is already going too long. Okay? Hinduism. I'll do another video on Tai Chi some other time. You guys are like, oh, come on, man. Talk more about Tai Chi. That was great. No. Hinduism teaches you how to worship, you know what I'm saying? How to find the darshan, you know what I'm saying? How to see the universe, how to really feel your capacity for the magic, you know? Hinduism teaches you how to use the energy inside of you that is present in Taoism. And Tai Chi is in Hinduism. It's called Shivaling. So the concept, is the binary concept, okay? That, and that doesn't represent dualism. That's a false understanding of it, okay? It is a dualism sometimes. It does make a dualism sometimes, but it's always a unity. It's always a relationship. It's always a connection. Anyways, Hinduism teaches you how to see the divinity in everything around you. It teaches you how to worship all of the forms of wonderment and beauty and goodness and holiness and wonderfulness and righteousness and loveliness and all the good things in the world. You know what I'm saying? Hinduism teaches you how to appreciate what really matters. It'll teach you how to simplify your life while still retaining a great, you know, beautiful relationship that is expressive and creative. That's darshan. That's what it's all about. It's all about making an art, a yoga out of yourself. The yoga, you know what I'm saying? And the awareness of the body through the meditation, through the fucking kundalini fucking transcendental consciousness, through the awareness of the body, the awareness of the breath, the awareness of the mind, the holistic method. Anthropology is really like the province of Hinduism in a major way. That's why theosophy and, you know, I mean, come on, what do you think happened there? That's why it's that way. Hinduism is the shit. It's the kinakang, and if you don't understand it all, Christianity is based on Hinduism. Christianity is really not that much based on Judaism. It's kind of based on Judaism and the practices that the people took forward in the very beginning. But the real philosophy that the dude instilled in these people was, you know, a mixture of Greek and Hindu awareness. And I'm also a Greek. You know, I'm a Greek that got thrown out. I'm going to leave that out for just now. It's a Buddhist, all right? That there is an awareness that you come to after you go through all of this stuff. Okay? And that is respect. That is namaste. That is compassion. You realize that other things are just as you are. You know? And you realize that this great, infinite, chaotic stream is all just rising and falling, and none of it really matters that much. So you learn to accept the emptiness. You learn to become the compassionate being. Okay? But we can't stop there, because we have to get to Christianity for that thing to be fulfilled. And I'm going to talk about that when we get to Christianity. But right now, I'm going to talk about being Jewish. Okay? Judaism is about communism. It's about revolution. It's about tying a string around your people and saying, it's about not breaking the motherfucking kinakang. You know what I'm saying? When you make the covenant, when you become part of the group, when you get in to the clique, you don't go outside of it. You know what I'm saying? It sets the rules for social relationships. That's how we do our thing. You know what I'm saying? The Judaism thing is, you know, you got to be contrarian. You want to write shit down. You want to read, study up. Let's argue about it. Let's talk about it. Let's laugh about it. Let's cry about it. Let's sing about it. Let's dance about it. Let's write some motherfucking poems. We got this whole universal concept worked out. It's called Cabalism. Here's a Sephiroth. Tree of Life looks just like a molecule for a reason. You know what I'm saying? A molecule looks like a molecule for a reason. When you see Misho Kaku on the cover of some magazine at the, you know, grocery store, and it's got all these little bubbles with bars behind them trying to express reality, that's Cabalism, baby. That's the what's up, you know what I'm talking about? Yeah, for sure. Anyways, Judaism, respect, much respect to that shit. You know, make your little neo-tribalistic group and fucking put your walls up, you know what I'm saying? That's the only way you really can do it in this world, huh? But you know what the idea should be? Fucking let's all get along, you know? We shouldn't be, you know, treating each other so poorly, because then if we start doing that on a massive scale, all kinds of people get fucking diaspora, you know what I'm saying? They get fucking holocausted, they get genocide. This fucking a history lesson on how to have humanity fucking pull itself out of this crazy, you know, sand pit warfare thing we got going on here. You know, the Sarlacc pit. We're all fighting over Las Vegas. Anyways, that's Judaism, you know what I'm saying? To me, that's how I interpret that. You know what I'm saying? It's about setting these standards for yourself. It's about understanding that there's only two things you should not do, really, is to fucking injure and steal from others. You know what I'm saying? Every single one of the 10 talents, as I've been told, it's told, you know, is not a commandment. It's 10 talents that tell you all the time that fucking thing that says to you, you know, be nice, don't take things from other people, and don't hurt anyone. Sounds like good advice for making a decent society. I love Jewish people. I can't wait to be one of them. If I can convert, let me know. You're a rabbi out there? Respect. Namaste. Let's be friends. Okay, now Christianity. I want to talk about this. There was a time when you had to elevate the Buddha's reality. You had to elevate where the Buddha got past all of the, you know, the formulas and the pomp and circumstance, and got down to the raw, nasty simplicity and the pain and the suffering of the universe, and realized that you couldn't do anything about it, so you might as well go on the inner journey and learn how to appreciate everything so that you can learn from it and have an experience that teaches you something, you know? Have an experience that moves you, have an experience that gives you a shift, a perspective of mind, so that you can, you know, but that's not enough. See, because when you get to the point where you have compassion for all beings, that's when you get back to working. That's when you get back to carrying wood and chopping, you know, chopping wood and carrying water. You know what I'm saying? That's when life becomes, again, it doesn't, nothing goes away. The condition doesn't change. You remove yourself from the little fucking social monkey game. You've defeated your ego. You've defeated your fucking social programming. You've become the fucking one who is awake and walks in the world with purpose. But that purpose is for others, you know, and that's the reality of it. And if you don't have that, you're not there, you know what I'm saying? I was born there, you know what I'm saying? But hey, that's because I've been reincarnating since way before the Dalai Lama, all right? Anyways, was that Buddhism? Oh wait, no, Christianity, okay. So this is the thing about Christianity. Is when you care about other people, compassion is ugly, it's fucking mean, it is, it's raw, it's real, it means that you will get down in them trenches with them dirty ass people who are dying and shitting and pissing and bleeding all over the place, and you gonna hold on to them and fucking just sit there and cry with them, because sometimes there's nothing else you can do, you know? It's a willingness to take that simplicity on. It's a fucking rage that you will stand up against the oppressors, that you will fucking claim justice and vengeance for the fucking poor and the fucking oppressed. You know, that's what Christianity is. Christianity is stoicism, simplicity, asceticism. It's meditation. It's fucking, it's tea and rice and beans. That's what it is. If you don't like it, you think you got a different fucking version, you need to read the fucking Gospels and spend less time reading other people's books and read more fucking the dude who fucking created that shit, and don't read what people did with it afterward. That's stupid, you know? Everything from Acts to Revelations needs to be scrapped. It's a bunch of crap. If you want to know what Christianity is, read Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, then read Thomas. Alright? Like, seriously, you want to know something more about Jesus? Go read the Quran, okay? He's in there a whole bunch. Anyways, Christianity is about learning to agree with people when they set you off. It's not about being, you know, capable of walking away from the pain. It's not about trying to get away from the suffering. It's about going towards the suffering. Okay? Christianity is about fucking saying, yeah, I'm not only going to give myself up, but I'm willing to go to the fucking ultimate dive for that. I'm willing to fucking lay myself down. I'm willing to fucking get pierced and ventilated and fucking perforated for other people. I'm willing to fucking go out into society and instead of getting a job or fucking making myself rich or doing something for myself or whatever, I'm going to fucking help other people's reality come true. You know what I'm saying? So when you see me out there, you say, what the fuck? How's this guy Christian? I'll tell you how I'm Christian, okay? This is the thing about me. Fucking when you need somebody to help you move, call me. I'll do it for free. You know what I'm saying? I'll come over and fucking move your whole house. Just like that. Lickety split. It ain't no shit. And you'll be like, well, what you want for this? And I'll be like, oh, nothing, man. It's cool. Fucking good. Fine. Fist bump. Hey, you have a good day. You don't even know me. I keep my life and my schedule clean and clear so that when my homeboy calls me at 1:30 in the morning from the motherfucking other city and says, hey man, I need somebody to come pick me up. I'm fucked up. Fucking my lady just fucking called the cops on me and they almost took me to the motherfucking joint and I need a ride back home to the fucking other city fucking 3 hours away. I'm like, hey yeah man, no problem, I'll come and do it. I'll be there in 3 hours, you know what I'm saying? Fucking 10 minutes, 30 minutes, whatever it takes, you know? I'm the kind of guy, fucking, when I go past somebody on the freeway, sometimes I'll go back and pick them up again, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't pick up everybody, though, you know what I'm saying? And that's one of the realities of Christianity that you gotta live with. It's hard, you know what I'm saying? Is that, fucking, when you deal with crazy, nasty, shitty, fucking, drunken, fucking, dangerous people, fucking, you can't trust them with everything. You got a fucking 8-year-old kid, you know what I'm saying, and a lady. You got to keep your fucking shit in check, connect, you know what I'm saying? So you got to have an edge, you got to have some hardness to you. You got to be able to fucking know when to say when and shake the dust off your motherfucking sandals and move on. You got to know when to say, hey, no, Legion, you need to fuck, you know, your shackles are gone, but you can't come with. You got to stay here and kick it with these people. You know what I'm saying? You got to know when you can say, hey, lady, you don't even know what you're asking, and your sons are not, they didn't make the cut. You know, you have to know when you can't do that, when you can't do that, what you're going to do, anything like that, right? That's, you get to feel it, you get to have a relationship with this thing, so you can feel who, when, where, what, why, and then what we want to do is we want to create enough of ourselves and all these different, you know, formulations and wavelengths and variables that they can all go out and soak up suffering, like white blood cells and a fucking social human network, you know? That's Christianity to me. I understand there's some motherfuckers out there right now, they think Christianity is about being stupid and thinking the earth's only 6,000 years old and hating gay people, hating Muslims, hating Buddhists, hating fucking anybody who's not just like them, hating other Christians, fucking joining military, fucking being police officer, fucking kicking people's ass, put them in cage, fucking get all the money, spend, buy, more, fucking support capitalism, vote Republican, that's Christianity to you? Really? you're in a lot of motherfucking trouble if you've been taking my motherfucking sacraments and doing my rituals and praying in my name and you're fucking doing all that stuff. Let me tell you something, your eternal soul, I wouldn't want to be you, but that's just a message to white America, straight from the fucking king who created that shit. What the fuck do you think this is? Can a bang bang? Alright, now, how am I Muslim? I'm going to tell you something. I keep my fucking five commitments every fucking day. First and foremost, I am loyal to the intelligence of the universe that creates me, that bore me out of it, that fucking transmits me safely, fucking through one life to the next, that fucking brought me into this existence, that put me inside of my mother, that made me who I am, that gave me this awareness, that fucking did everything for me. This is my life, this is it, this is the existence I have, everything that is around me. Woo, are you kidding me? I'm loyal to that shit, no bar none, baby. That shit is, I'm on tip with Allah, you know what I'm saying? So I got the first one down, alright? I have to have no God but Allah. And I know Muhammad is the prophet. Peace be upon him. So, that's the first one. The second one is that you have to have a study. And boy, let me tell you something. I have studied. I've read the fucking Vedas. I've read the Upanishads. I've read the Mahabharata. I've read the Ramayana. I've read the fucking Dhammapada. I've read the Tao Ching. I've read the Lao Tzu. I've read the Song Tzu. I've read the Sun Tzu. I've read, you know, the I Ching. I've read, you know, you don't like read the I Ching, but I have read the I Ching. The best I Ching is Gyo Fu Feng's I Ching. It's from the 60s. It's nice, and it comes with a manual on how to do Tai Chi Chuan, and it's fucking awesome. It's the best I Ching there is. But anyways, I've read the other I Chings too. Anyways, all right. So scripture study again. You have to read, right? Fucking, I was telling you. Hinduism, Taoism, Buddhism, you know, I've studied the shit out of Buddhism. I could tell you, if you put 12 monks in front of me, all different from different regions, I could probably tell you where each one of them were from just by looking at them, see how they're dressed, etc. I know the differences between certain types of, you know, styles, what Hinayana, what Mahayana, what's Theravada, what is fucking Vajrayana, what is fucking Chosen, fucking, you know, everything, Japanese style, you know, different Japanese styles, how Buddhism articulates with Taoism, how it articulates with Hinduism, how it re-articulates with itself, how it articulates with Muslims and fucking places like Indonesia, you know, that's, I understand Buddhism pretty well. And I can do a lot on Buddhism. I know how Buddhism fits with everything else. Buddhism is even compatible with Christianity. It's compatible with Judaism. It's even compatible with Islam if you're an open-minded Muslim. You know, some Muslims aren't, just like Christians aren't. Some Buddhists aren't. So, you know, not that many. But there's a foul to think that Buddhism is a perfect religion. But at any rate, I've read the Tanakh. Okay. I've read the Dead Sea Scrolls. I've read some Mishnah, some Midrash. You know what I'm saying? I've studied, you know, some of, like, for example, like the great writers, Kaplan. You know, fucking, I know who Sokhtav Zwai is. You know, like Maimonides. Really, come on, like I'm very appreciative of the Jewish history and the Jewish literature that has arisen over the years. I know all kinds. I've read the Zohar. You know, I've read a few books on Kabbalism itself, but not too many. Kabbalism is more of an experience for me, and I'm an autodidact. I do read, but I'm much more osmotic when it comes to my reading. Anyways, I'm a contrarian, etc. All these things. All right. Anyways, this is on books, Christianity. I've read the Nag Hammadi. What more does need to be said? But again, and then Islam, right? I've read the Quran. So there you go. I got all my bases covered. And I've read other things too. So I study. That's the second pillar of Islam. I believe in Allah. And I fucking am loyal to Allah. And I fucking study. Okay? Next thing. I make pilgrimage, which I have all kinds of pilgrimages. I keep them all the time. I plug in, I do things, I go places, I do things that I have to do that are fucking, you know, that are ritual intentions to keep, right? I can't go to Kaaba because I'm not full Muslim, like accepted and shit. I do go to Masjid, but not always and everything. I would like to go to Kaaba by the end of my life. I would convert to full Muslim by the end of my life to go to Kaaba, because to make Hajj is the most important thing. That is amazing for me. I would love to get next to the Black Rock, you know? But anyways, that doesn't, but see, that's the thing. You can make pilgrimage all over the world, you know, pilgrimage to this place, pilgrimage to that place, you know, pilgrimage to Earth. For Bodhisattva vow that I have, you know. Anyways, zakat, as I told you, I pay my zakat. I'm fucking always there. If you need something, I got it for you. I'm gonna help you out. You want me to babysit? Done. Fucking, that's all there is to it. It's I'm ready to help you. You know what I'm saying? Whoever you are, no matter what, I'm always ready to help anyone who comes up to me. That's my zakat, and I don't always give everything I have to everyone all the time. That's true. It's not, I'm not gonna be like naked in the street for fucking some crackhead to just smoke off my fucking clothes. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can't just give everything to everyone. You have to know where is the balance, right? But I pay zakat, so there you go. I pray nonstop. I don't pray just 5 times a day. I pray all day, every day, constantly, 100% meditation running in the back of my mind all the time. Never do I separate the dialogue between me and Allah. It doesn't ever happen. It's never happened once. The only time it happens is when I get drunk and pass out. And then it doesn't even happen then, because there's going through like computer programming things, auto updates. Did I have the 5 pillars of Islam? I don't remember if I have them all or not. See, I pay zakat, I pray, I will make a pilgrimage, I fucking study, and I believe in Allah. You see? I'm also pagan and all kinds of other things. I love theosophy, I love anthropology, and I believe in none and all. You see? Now, some people, they don't like it, they don't understand, they think to themselves, oh, that's all bullshit, none of that exists. Good for you. But you're not much of a scientist if you can't decipher any of what I just said. Let me tell you something. All right, that's it. Goodbye.